one's live. That's live. Okay, that camera's live. That's some reason stop pushing this to Twitter. Interesting. Hello, everyone. Good evening. Happy Wednesday. I've got an awesome, awesome new announcement to make tonight, and I'm quite excited to do it. And I'll announce that after I give you a quick tour. This is Girl, special guest right here, Tori Smith. Introduce yourself.
Oh, hi. Yes, Tori Smith. Take the lead, canine training. We're in Orlando, Florida right now.
All right.
Okay. Hey, Julie.
And everyone's going to be able to do, Tori's going to make a comment, and I want everybody to start following her. And this is Romy with her new t-shirt. Let's see the shirt.
Yeah.
Yay.
Show the back.
You're getting lots of hi, Tori's.
Hi.
Awesome. And there's Angelo, who's tired.
I'm not tired.
Oh, he's not tired.
He'll be asleep by the end of the show.
There's Clover.
I'm tired.
All right, this is it. Little RV party.
What about me? You didn't introduce me.
This is Linda.
Thank you. Jeez.
So, hey, everybody. It's Jeff Gellman. Now, we're going to announce. Let me just show you something really, really cool that we're doing right now. I'm really excited to share this with everybody. But first, let me just tell you who I am and what I do. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. And I've got a, we'll hit 3 million on this scope. We'll hit 3 million on this scope. And I've got a training facility in Providence, Rhode Island. And we specialize in aggression rehab. And we do a lot of board and training and one-on-ones. And I also work with a lot of behavior modification cases. But I travel the world doing seminars. And you can go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. But let me just show you something really, really cool before we get into the show.
Hey, Donnelly.
Let me see if I can pick this up on my screen. This is me right here in the corner, the upper right-hand corner of the screen. That is my Catch account now. So now, if you go to my website, Solid Canine Training, right? And you click on this.
You
go to my Catch account and you can get all of my past periscopes. Look at all of them right
nice.
There. All of my periscopes. You'll never miss another periscope again. So that's pretty, pretty cool. Yes, Tori is cuddling with everybody.
Yes, I got dogs.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
Yes, that's Vicky. We're actually in Victoria's house tonight, and she's letting us, as they say in RV world, she's letting us plug in. And actually, I'm going to be interviewing Tori after. Linda, we have to get cozy tonight. I'm going to be interviewing Tori after the this periscope. I'm going to be doing a separate periscope interviewing her.
When am I going to do my periscope?
You're going to be in here by yourself. And we're going to do it in our house. All right. So,
you're looking for the cat.
The cat's inside. All right. So let's get right into the show. And if you see Tori just put up hello all, right? Hello all.
Okay.
And when you see someone put hello all, hello all, and show us what your dog, my dogs can't do anything. Hello all. Take the lead canine, click on that and follow her. All right, click on the follower. Okay, so I'm in my RV. My dogs do nothing in the RV. All right, that's what they do. All right, so also it's not about what my dogs do, it's about what other people's dogs, you know, can be doing as well. All right, let's get right into the questions. Who's got questions? This is a really important day, Mondays and Wednesdays. What I do is I answer people's dog training questions because I get so many requests on a daily basis to do that. Hey, Jeff, I have a 7-year-old pit mix who does wonderfully off-leash and is completely relaxed and responsive. Awesome. Cool. That was a statement. Great. But on leash, he freaks out. Okay. So that is actually really, really common. Your dog is leash reactive. And the reason why your dog is leash reactive, because the leash is a barrier. So believe it or not, your dog might actually have too much freedom and not enough rules and structures and guidance. So this happens all the time. So what I want you to do is, we're a big fan of remote collars. We're balanced dog training. So we do 90% yes, and maybe 10% no. So what I want you to do is, though, is learn how to teach your dog how to be remote cower healed. Remote cower healed. So remote cower is going to be your friend on every single thing you do. So remote cower healing, but also teach your dog how to walk properly on a leash. We're a big advocate of different tools. So use a prong cower to start. So prong cower, remote cower, get the dog to heel next to you. No pulling, no lunging, no marking, nothing at all like that. So that's what we want to be. She can't handle it. So what I want you to do is, what you've got to do is you've got to get that dog closer to you. Okay. You got to get that dog closer to you. Work away from distractions. Start it inside. Start it in your backyard. Start it out slow and don't get frustrated. What you don't want to do is you don't want to get frustrated with your training. That happens a lot with a lot of people, is we get frustrated. Then the problem is the dogs pick up on that frustration and they're just not interested in anything we've got to tell them. Anything they got to tell them. All right. So let's try it with that. All right. If your dog is e-cower smart, what we tell people to do is whenever you're home, put the equipment on. Do you put the training equipment on for the day and then take it off at night? If you're going to be, the cower is going to be on for the dogs for more than 4 hours, rotate a remote cower on each side of the dog's neck. And then what I want you to do is I want you to make sure that you are always working that dog, And don't get the dog to be cower smart. So that's really important. There was a question. Let me just tell something else. There's a little character in the corner. Click on the little character in the corner. And you can share this on Facebook. You can share this on Twitter. You can share this on Periscope. Also, you want to start following me. Come on to my followers and turn on your alerts. The hearts are showing up because, we just hit 3 million. The hearts are showing up because we lose hearts. We lose probably almost 50% of our hearts because you can only do 500 hearts for Periscope. So by clicking on the screen is what you get the hearts. What happens is also on the replays, you can share the show on the replays. You can also give me hearts on the replays. A lot of people didn't even know that. So don't forget that if you're watching this on a replay, heart me up. And you do that by, you know, clicking the screen. Somebody asked a question about, can you redirect your dog if it's biting? If you're training I say absolutely not. Absolutely not. You're training your dog to bite, actually. But if you're working a sport dog, I'm not a sport dog trainer. I'm a family dog trainer. Nobody wants their dog to bite. Sport dog trainers do. Some sport dog trainers will always theoretically reward the dog for biting. Being a family dog trainer, we stop biting. And then personally, I'd rather stop the dog biting completely, and then I can always train it to do controlled biting. All right? Your dog, your dog bites you and then you give it something else. You've actually trained your dog to bite. And for all the people that are welcome, I was actually going to do a little Snapchat on the videos that I did. All right. So what else do we got? Yep.
Dog keeps hiding from loud noises such as thunder.
Okay. So your dog is a little bit phobic. So what I want you to do is what I want you to do is get a soundtrack. Get a soundtrack of all different sounds: thunder, lightning, fireworks, babies crying, you know, loud trucks. Start playing that at a very, very low level. And then work it up. And I also want you to feed your dog and do food training during that protocol. And you actually can correct the out of controlness when the thunder happens, and then get the dog to be a calming state. That doesn't mean you're correcting it constantly. You're correcting the dog the first time when it freaks out, and then have it go to place or have it go to a down. That's what I want you to do. But be super, super careful. Super, super careful. Do I allow my dog? My dogs don't eat treats. My dogs eat out of a bowl. But would I allow my kids to give my dogs treats if they ate treats? Of course I would. Yeah. My dogs could do that, but they don't eat treats. So they just eat their daily food. That's it. That's all they need. All right. Next.
Young dog pees a little when I first greet him, even if I put him in place.
So what I want you to do is this. Check out if your dog was recently spayed or neutered. And see what's up with that. Also, your dog, check out for a UTI, but it's mostly, yes, that is Tori right behind me. Say hi, Tori. What chances are is it's excitement pee. So what I want you to do is you're going to have to start getting your levels, your level of your coming in and leaving a little bit lower, coming in and leaving a little bit lower. But Brian, I think your dog is young. It will probably, hopefully go away. You know, probably go away. That's a hard one. That's a hard one. Bitter apple works on it. I don't do, was neutered a month ago. It could be from the neutering. What I would do is I would take, okay, was it happening prior to the neutering, Brian? Happening prior to the neutering? Okay, what's next?
Remote collar heel. What would you recommend more with using a slip lead or a prong collar?
I would start with a prong collar. You could always switch to a martingale if you wanted to, but you might as well do a prong collar. So if it wasn't happening before it, I would talk to your vet about that then, Brian. I would talk to your vet. So dog wasn't doing excitement pee prior to surgery, went in for surgery, and then now it's doing it. Talk to your vet about that. There might be an issue. Okay. That might be an issue. All right. When your dog chews, when your dog is chewing something, I don't redirect and I don't use bitter apple. I correct. So remote collar correction. So remember, when we use remote collars, probably 10% at high levels and 90% at low levels. Now, low level does not mean below 10. It just means a working level of the dog that it's going to be something similar to this. Okay, but you chew something, I will correct you. All right, that's just the way it is. Facts of life. Your dog could die from chewing something. The bottom line, your dog could die, so it has to be corrected. And remember, when you're correcting a dog, they're called calm corrections. What I would do is, remember, you're not mad at the dog, angry at the dog, upset with the dog. It's just a matter of fact. Oh, can't do that. Sorry, can't do it. Chewing on something? Nope, not allowed to do it. No yelling, no screaming, nothing. Okay. How do you find out what the working level number is? I've got a video on that. Watch my video on how to introduce a remote collar to a dog. What you're going to want to do is make sure the collar is on super, super snug. You want to make sure you've got good contact. And you just start at zero and you work your way up. And you're looking for an ear twitch, an eye blink like this. But I've got a video on that. All right, next question.
Catahoula listens reluctantly on leash and prong. Very little eye contact. Problem?
Okay, this is what I want you to do. I want you to do focus drills. Tomorrow, inside and outside are always different levels because you've got distractions. Remember that. Don't be married to a number, okay? Now, this is wife number six for me, but I don't call her wife number six. I call her ma'am because we've got that type of tight personal relationship. I used to call her honey, but she elbowed me, so I called her ma'am. But I definitely don't call her number six. Don't be married to a number. Don't worry about the number. Don't worry about the number. Put a piece of tape over the numbers. Watch the dog. So what was the question?
What?
I don't even know the question was. Focus. Focus drills. Ah, of course. I'm going to do a focus periscope with Tori's dog. What's that German Shepherd's name?
We've got Sadie. But I was thinking about it. She's got pretty good focus, but I've got a nervous cattle dog.
So we're going to do a, can we do a focus drill tomorrow on that? So I'm going to use Tori's dogs I've never seen before or never met, and they'll be coming in for the very first time. So I'm going to do is I'm going to do some focus periscopes. We're going to do a lot of fun periscopes tomorrow. I know, street card, I know. So also I'm interviewing Tori later tonight. All right, what's next?
My dog is e-collar trained and doing great, but is freaking out whenever she sees a man with a beard or a hat.
Okay, so what I don't want you to do is, I was going to make a joke about a certain ethnicity, but that's probably not appropriate because, but then again, I'm Jewish and I make Jewish jokes all the time, but still that's not acceptable. What I would do is, as far as a beard, your dog is not socialized with bearded people. So what I want you to do is you actually can put on fake stuff, eyeglasses, hoods, fake beards, big coats. Have yourself a little like dress up kit and introduce your dog to other people. Don't yawn on my show, Tori, or you'll be asked to leave. Okay, I take it personally. Okay, my ego has just been crushed. My ego has been crushed again. It's funny. I almost feel like I'm in bed right now because all the women that are with me are yawning. So, and this sort of looks like our bedroom and two women and me. No? Okay, that was wife number five, maybe, and that didn't last long. Anyway, back to dog training. So what I want you to do is I want you to desensitize your dog.
Don't encourage it.
Desensitize your
dog. I don't need espresso. I've got something special in
okay,
my mug.
Okay. Desensitize your dog to people with beards, and you're going to be doing a food protocol with that. All right. Right. Hey, for all of you that are laughing, I love all of you even more. Okay. I'm giving you hearts. I'm giving you hearts. I'm giving you hearts. All right. What's the next question?
Dog nose heel.
Yes.
Dialed up stim during proofing.
Yes.
Now doesn't want to heel. Give the dog more pressure?
Or less pressure. You might be doing the dog too much pressure. So what I want you to do is I want you to do remote collar heel. Tori, do you have a remote collar healing video?
I do.
All right. Tori's got a remote collar healing video. So you would actually clicker train to love beards. Actually, you would. What you're going to do is you might be going up too high. Play with the numbers. With remote collar heel, it's almost like fishing, meaning you're sort of like, you throw the rod out, you go like this, you go like this, you go like this, put it on continuous, put it on momentary, a little bit lower, a little bit higher, keep your body moving. Try different things. Every dog responds to remote collar healing a little bit different. Next question.
1-year-old German Shepherd dog attacked our 11-year-old terrier mix, also went after 6-year-old son yesterday.
Okay, that's a major problem. As you already know that's why you're calling. That's all something. Hey, whoa, Cangelo, I'll freaking shut this show down right here.
Should be one of those that says there might be wine in here.
No. This is one of the best parts of her day. All right. Okay. Let's clarify that right now. All right.
Are you asking me?
No, that was a statement. Did I just lie?
Lie.
Am I making false statements? Shit. All right, Donnelly. All right. So what I want you to do is, damn it, I don't even know what we were talking about. What else?
You were talking about the shepherd that went after the dog.
Oh, okay. Thank you. A big one. So the shepherd that went after the dog, the dog and the kid, that is something that cannot be done on a Periscope. And I'm not trying to get you to do a Skype visit, but that is not periscopable. But I work with that type of dog. There are way too many variables, way too many. I don't drink alcohol. I've been sober for 20 years. Thanks for bringing back bad memories. I hope I don't start drinking tonight because of you, Chrissy. Thank you so much.
What?
Chrissy's accusing me of having wine. What? What's next? Cocaine, right?
It goes from wine to cocaine.
That's what I used to do a lot of.
What, right? Wine and cocaine?
I didn't do wine. I did tequila, cocaine, mushrooms, and pot. Anyway, so what I want you to 20 years sober, folks, 20 years. All right. So what I want you to do is this. What I want you to do is you've got to contact me, and there's going to be a fee for that. And I'm not saying that just to get money out of you. What you can do is you can go to my website and fill out a training contract. The issue is this, there is so many variables from how the dog is sleeping, how it's eating, how you come home, the energy of the house, the layout of the house, what the kids are doing, what the dogs are doing, your feeding protocols, your leadership skills, how they go in and out of doors. There's so many variables, and I don't mean to blow you off right now, but that's what I do for a living, and that's what we're really good at with a rehab. All right, we're really good at the rehab. All right, what's next?
Reactive pit couldn't care less about prong or stim under 20.
Okay, guess what? Go over 20, all right? Don't be married to a number. Don't be married to a number. Thanks, Tom. Tom, by the way, I love you, and I think you're brand new to my life. Tom, are you new? I don't know if I've ever seen you before. Who's new? Type in new. Who's new? Type in new, please. It's another little thing you can do. Okay. All right. So who's new? Also ask people where they're from. Okay. Right. So who's new? All right. New. Awesome. Awesome. Sparrow Tucker, look at you. Oh, my God. The next 18. Welcome.
Sweet.
Trask. Oh, my gosh. Reagan. Yeah. Tom. Awesome. I love you. Brian, King Canine, I'm chubby. Hey, that's okay. I'm chubby too. All right. New, look at this. Not new. Oh, Terry, please. Okay, you're not new at all. That doesn't make you old, but you're not new, Terry. All right. So, next question. Welcome all. Welcome. I do this every Monday and Wednesday. Julian, you're not old at all. If you are, you're the sexiest, oldest person I know. What's next?
Aha. Dog is reactive and fearful. He's bit 8 people. Where do I even start?
Okay. You start by contacting me. Any dog that's bitten 8 people, let alone 2 people, let alone 1 person, it's not periscopable. But this is what you need to do. This is what you're going to need to do. Bottom line, is train your dog on all baseline obedience. No matter what you do, you have to do it anyway. I want that dog to be kenneled. So for all the folks out there that have got aggressive dogs, let alone all dogs, you are to kennel your dog at night. You are to kennel your dog at home when you are away from the house. I want that dog always in place. I always want that dog in a down stay. That's that. I want that dog to learn how to properly walk on a leash. I know how to want that dog how to do a down, place, sit. All right. That's what I want for that dog. Okay. That dog gets no free roaming at all. I want all affection taken away from that dog right now. I want that dog to have no free roaming. I want that dog to have massive amounts of structure. Do not let that dog bark at anything out the window. That's that. All right. Whenever the family's eating, I want it kenneled up. That's not going to fix the problem, but boy, is that going to be a big wake-up call for that dog. Okay? That's how I can help you right now on Periscope for your aggressive dogs. All right? That's how I can do. All right? Your dog stares, jumps up, and snaps in people's faces when they visit the house. Jessica, why is your dog having contact with people? All right? I'm going to be a little bit of a dickish to you right now. But I love you, Jessica. I love you.
Is it you're going to be dickish or you're going to be a dickish?
I'm going to be a dickish and dickish. I'm going to be twice as amount of dick that you've ever seen me before.
Whoa.
All right.
That's a little naughty.
That's what I wanted on my wedding night, but it did not happen. I was actually half the amount because I was nervous. It's my first time. Listen.
Wedding was that? Not ours.
It was wife number one. Listen. I want that dog on a leash. Okay. Okay. She's very cute. Okay.
Yeah.
But she's taken. All right.
Okay.
She's our third wheel, you know,
rough
whatever.
Baller.
Right. She's our on the road girlfriend.
Yeah.
All right. So this is what I want you to do is I want that dog on a leash. I don't want that dog going. I don't want that dog going to the door. I don't want that dog going to the door. All right. I know Victoria. I mean, I'm sorry. I know Jessica. I don't want that dog going towards the door. What I want you to do is I want you to learn the place command. I want you to learn the place command. I've got a free video on that. You teach place. Also, what I want you to do is this. That you're going to role play going towards the door. Role play going towards the door. So that means somebody else will ring the doorbell, knock on the door. If your dog runs towards the door. Okay. Imagine this is a big towel. Okay, bigger than this. And I want you to put elastic. All right. I want you to have three of those ready to go. The dog, the dog, what I want you to do is if the dog races towards the door, you are to say no, throw a towel. If the dog doesn't move, throw another towel. That's what I want you to do. Oops, sorry. I said no and my dog broke command. Hold on. Girl plots. Thank you. All right. That's what I want you to do. I want you to teach that dog place. I want that dog. You throw it just at the dog. Go for the head. It's a towel. You cannot hurt this dog with a towel. All right. How many times have we all been playing chuck it or fetch? On the dog, at the dog, right at the dog. Bam, bam, bam. You won't hurt the dog. It literally is a cotton towel. Boom, boom, boom. Okay? All right? Next. Shelter dog destroys toys. Shelter dog destroys toys. Don't let it have any toys. What's next?
I was ready. I accidentally went too high with trying to find working level and dog is scared. Now
all right,
what?
This is what I want you to do. Don't worry about it. I've made that mistake too. Just to let you know. Okay, folks, you've got two dog trainers back here. Okay, Linda is just the beautiful wife of a good looking dog trainer.
That's all I am.
For the radio show, yes.
Linda is just.
For now it is.
I'm just Linda.
I know. That's it. Okay. So two dog trainers right here. I make tons of mistakes. I make a ton of mistakes every day. I make mistakes in my marriage. I make mistakes as a father. I make mistakes as a boss. I make mistakes with myself and my own personal self. I make mistakes eating. I make mistakes exercising. I make mistakes as a dog trainer. I make mistakes as a community member. Don't worry about it. Move on. Start with food. I want you to do food protocols with the remote. Leash, food, remote. Your dog will be fine. Don't feel bad for it. Don't apologize. What's done is done. All right, next question.
Doing a remote collar heel. Dog doesn't want to heel at all now.
You might have gone too high. All right? You might have gone too high. Right? Right?
You want me to go on?
All right. Rough baller. All right? She's a guest on the show. All right? Thank you. Let's go on. He's about to be deleted. Yep. Go ahead.
I would have already.
That's okay.
Do you ever do one simple behavior mod like counter surfing in one training session?
You could. But yeah, so in other words, okay. So you could, because it might shut down the dog. it might shut down the dog. So if someone doesn't understand that question, counter surfing, I fix one way only because it works. One way and one way only because it works. Dogs die daily. Okay. Dogs die daily from counter surfing. All right. If they don't die, it's a $3,000 to $5,000 surgery to get whatever is out of their stomach. Remote collar on the dog. This is when you go high. Remote collar on the dog. What you do is you put food up on the counter. You leave the room. You look through a window. You look through a camera that has real time. By the way, make sure it has real time video. And then you correct high. That's it. How high? Highest it goes. Hold the button down for 3 seconds. You should not enjoy it. It's not pretty to see, but your dog will die. If it doesn't die, trust me, the operation will be painful and it will not be pretty either. Okay.
I think the person who accidentally went too high, they want to know like what they're going to be able to do now.
What I would do is just start from the beginning with food. Start with food. Your dog is pooping all over the house. You should kennel up your dog at night, kennel up your dog when you're not in the house. Also, don't have your eyes off your dog. No free roaming right now. Also, what I want you to do is make your dog go out on a regular schedule. Feed it on a regular schedule. Make sure you're not overfeeding your dog. Most dogs only poop twice a day. All right, twice a day. So, all right, next.
Do you use e-collar on all dogs at RV Dog Trainer, or is it individualized to the dog's issues?
Yes and no. Dog training is individualized to the issues, but all dogs, most people that come to RV Dog Trainer want their dogs remote collar trained, but you don't have to use a remote collar in RV Dog Trainer. You don't have to, but it's a great way to train your dog. It's actually the kindest, gentlest way to train a dog, and you can whisper, you can shout up to a mile away. All right. So your dog is mounting your leg, correct it. Correct your dog high. That's really disrespectful. Really, really disrespectful for your dog doing that. You can use a remote collar. What I would do is this. I would have somebody stand behind you with your dressage whip, and you're not beating your dog. You're not whipping your dog. And, you know, and what I would do is give your dog a quick swat on the butt with a dressage whip. Yes, Jessica, you can watch this on the replay organically on Periscope for up to 24 hours. This immediately gets up to my catch account. You can get my catch going by to my website. By the way, this is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Go to my website, Solid Canine Training, solidcaninetraining.com. You can go to my website right there and you can get to my catch account right on the top menu. Also, don't forget on the replays, you can give me hearts. On the replays, you can share. You swipe right to left on an iOS and up and down on an Android. Also, right now, the little characters in the corner, share me on Facebook, share me on Twitter, share me on Periscope. Join me. Join my social media. I'm on Snapchat. I'm on Instagram. I'm on YouTube. I'm on Facebook. Join me. I spend a lot of time on social media 100% for free. I do 20 hours of Periscope a week. All right. And I'm still running a business, running a family. I'm not saying this to brag, boast, or for ego, but I'm putting a lot of time into this. Please take advantage of all the free stuff that I offer. All right. Because your dog, if you've got a badly behaved dog, guess what? It's better off in your house than anywhere else. Please don't give up your dog. All right. Nobody gives a shit about your dog but you. All right. Thank you. What else? Remote collars can be, I've got 9 dogs. All right. Remote collars can be, so there's a lot of different names. All right. Remote collars can be, anywhere from a good one's gonna be around $180. Don't buy crap ones. E-collar technology, Dogtra, Sport Dog makes some decent ones as well. Right? We like ecollar.com. Ecollar.com. You go right to my website. I sell them on my website. All right. Okay. Her name is Victoria, and she's a guest. And behave, Brian. Right. What else?
Puppy raising a young lab that can't calm down around other dogs.
Okay.
Is that positive reinforcement, not negative?
So it's okay, Brian. I love you anyway. All right. I love you anyway. I just have to set rules here. All right. I've got 6 daughters, a wife. I'm really, really making sure that everybody acts accordingly. I'm the only one that's allowed to be inappropriate on this show. That's
and
it.
And then you get.
And then I get elbowed in the ribs. All right. Elbowed in the ribs.
Other places.
All right. Okay. Elbowed in other places. Okay. So this is what I want you to do. There's no such thing as positive only. Okay. There's no such thing as positive only, all right? And if you're talking about positive reinforcement and negative punishment, Sparrow, you know too much about dog training. You know you're reading too many books, or you're a trainer that doesn't understand aversives. And I don't say that be out of disrespect. All dog training is yes and no. Let's make it simple. All dog training is yes and no. Do this, Don't do that. Now, how do I motivate you to do this? Don't talk science. You're not allowed to talk science on my show, because if you want to talk science, there's actually four quadrants to science. Two of them are punishment. So I won't go into that discussion. Most people that talk science, this does not mean you, Sparrow, at all. By the way, when I go on to my rampages, none of this is directed at you, you folks, or anybody. It's a general statement. Most people that talk science, though, most dog trainers out there that say they use science-based dog training actually don't understand the science. They're not using science-based dog training. There's four quadrants to it. Two of them includes punishment, all right? Two of them includes punishment. So all dogs are punished. All dogs are aversive. Any dog trainer out there that says they don't use punishment, that means, you know what they don't do? Use leashes. A leash is a punishment. It keeps the dog from going somewhere. Anyway, so I can't, unless I can talk my normal language, I can't help you with your question. So, but I love you, Sparrow. Right, what else?
One that just came in. Will correcting a dog for lunging at people with a prong make it more fearful of people?
No, it will not. No, it will not. That's a lie. That's an outright blatant lie. Correcting dogs doesn't make them afraid of other people. That's an outright lie. That's propaganda put out by a massive machine of PR people out there to scare you, the dog owner. So it's not, okay? I got a clicker from Gary Wilkes. Contact Gary Wilkes. Just search him on YouTube. My clicker is from Gary Wilkes. I like his. Next.
Okay. Where do you get those place boards that you use?
Petcot. I get place boards from Petcot. Petcot.com. Use my name. They might give you a deal. Also, also you can get them from Climb. The black ones are from Climb. How do you know when to use a prong or e-cower? Start out with both. Start out with both. They're just tools. Just keep in mind also, tools train dogs. Tools train dogs. I'm sorry, dog. I was going on my rampage. Tools don't train the dog. Okay, the tool doesn't train. I was just thinking about getting a remote cower. I'm trying to think, do I even have a remote cower in this RV? The tool is not training the dog. Training trains the dog. Training is what trains the dog. So a prong cower helps communicate, and a remote cower helps communicate. Start out. You can start on either one. Start on either one. Next.
Dog listens better off leash in high distraction situations than alone and on leash with owner.
Okay, probably what's happening is the dog is frustrated. The dog is probably frustrated, all right? So what I would do is I would work on your basics. Work on your basics, work on your focus. Work on your basics and work on your focus. Okay, that's gonna be the important thing about that. Tim on the lab is doing well walking with prong cow, but I always have to use it. So Chrissy, this is the thing, Chrissy. No, you won't. No, you won't. Okay, you won't have to use it. You can use it whenever you want to, but this is what I say. Why wouldn't you use a tool that's connected to a leash that works? Do you know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? So you don't have to do it, okay? What I do is, if you're gonna be using a leash, have it on a collar that works. So say you have the leash to a flat buckle collar, I would ask, why do you have a leash on the dog? So why not have a prong collar? So prong collars are awesome. They're awesome tools. They're not negative at all. I wear my seatbelt every day. I actually won't move from parking spot to parking spot in a grocery store parking lot unless my seatbelt is on. I always do it. Why? Just in case. Just in case. All right, what's next?
Dog freaks out when we leave or if it's in a kennel. How do we get him to hush?
What I want you to do is, if you leave or you, one more time, when you leave?
Or put the dog in the kennel.
Putting it in?
If they leave, if they put the dog in the kennel, and then if they put the dog in the kennel and they leave.
Okay, bark collar. Get a bark collar. You're welcome, Chrissy, and I love you. You're welcome. Also, what I want you to do is teach that dog how to do a down in the kennel. Most people put the dog in the kennel and then they leave. What I want you to do is teach the kennel up command. Kennel up, down. Kennel up, down. Kennel up, down. Not you, girl. Girl's like, where's my kennel? Where's my kennel? Where's my kennel? Sorry. All right. So that's what I want you to do. All right. Jeff Gellman, solid canine training. Jeff Gellman, solid canine training. No, girl, that's enough. Girl, place. Good. Okay. Jeff Gellman, solid canine training. So someone asked me, what's my dog's name? Her name is Girl. All right. She just wanted to know. So, and I got two chihuahuas behind me too. All right. Next.
Are you doing a Toronto seminar?
Yes, I'm doing a Toronto seminar. I am, and it should be on rvdogtrainer.com. Go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. Lauren set it up, and Lauren booked it, and she just announced it. Lauren is my personal assistant back in Rhode Island. Give me hearts. Click on that little character in the screen. Share this on Facebook. Share this on Twitter. Like me everywhere. All right, like me on all my social media platforms. Next.
I work at home and spend an hour training. What do I do when not actively training my dog?
The dog, okay, the dog is, what you want to do is do duration work. So what I would do is this, do some structured walks, some structured play, right? And then do active training and then do duration work. Remember, having your dog in place or a down is training, all right? When walking my dog, it sneezes a lot. When he sees reactive dogs, should I correct him? Only if your dog's boogers get all over you. Other than that, leave it alone. Next.
How do you train commands in German when your dog already knows them in English?
Any other way, just like you would do it in English. Just start from the beginning. Start from the, take care, Tech. We love you. What I would do is say goodbye. Goodbye. Oh, you didn't see it yet. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, now you see it. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, you're on a little bit of a delay.
Yeah, I am. Good night, Tess. All right.
What I want you to do is this: is start from the beginning. Just give it a word. You can train your dog with vegetable names. Sit could be broccoli. Down could be squash. Recall could be pizza. You can say pizza. Boom, they'll go.
Is that a vegetable?
If it's a vegetarian pizza, it is. And tomato sauce is a fruit.
You know, Angelo calls his Mr. Potato Head Mr. Tomato Head.
Does he really?
Yeah.
That's a Rhode Island company too.
It is. Hasbro.
Next.
I don't have next. Next hasn't happened. What type of light do you use in your home office for scope?
What I'll do, I did a scope on that once. I use light boxes. Go on to Amazon.com and look up light boxes and get a light box. I brought one with me and I'm setting it up when we get down to Ellenton. All right? No, just say plots and put them in a down. Just say plots and put them in a down. Use shaping. Just shape your dog. Just use shaping. Leash pressure, shaping, or do a hand signal with a word. All right. If I looked at girl, tomorrow I'll do a demonstration. I'll call girl over to me and I will say to her, pizza. I'll look at her with my eyes because I talk to my dog with my eyes. I'll look at my dog and I'll say pizza. And I bet you 90% of the time she'll down. Why? Because she always downs when I say a word. That's why. Because I always put her in a down. All right? So what's next?
I don't have one.
Do you have anything next? Listen, go to, type that in. Type this in. RV dog training. RV dog training. RVdogtrainer.com.
No, that's always
RV dog trainer.com. RVdogtrainer.com. Go to that. Go to that website, rvdogtrainer.com, and I'm going to be in Ellenton, Florida. We got some spots, and we're doing a barbecue Saturday night. More of a statement, but I just can't figure out heel. I've watched your video several times. Nicholas, or Nicole's, what's the problem? What are you having a problem with? What are you having a problem with? All you want your dog to do is, you're in Winter Springs? Awesome. We're in Winter Springs. I'm in Winter Springs. Chrissy, I'm in Winter Springs.
That's what she just said. You're in Winter Springs.
Oh, I'm in Winter Springs. Yes, I'm in Winter Springs. Tomorrow I'll be, no, Friday I'll be in Ellenton. Tomorrow night I'll be in Ellenton. Dog, I'm going to be in Philadelphia. I've got a seminar in Philadelphia in August. The walks ahead all the time. Okay, so what I want you to do this is, Nichols, is I want you to do a couple 180 moves. I will demonstrate it tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll demonstrate it. Write these down. Can you write notes down?
My phone died, but I will
mention. Oh, shoot.
Remember, 180.
Focus 180 pizza. All right. All right. Hold on. I want to help Nichols here.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to do those videos tomorrow. I'm going to do Periscope
tonight.
Pizza, 180s, and focus work.
Okay.
Yes, you can go to the barbecue even if you're not going to the seminar. Yes. All right. Missed you guys in Virginia. When I looked up seminars, it was only a day or two away. You could have still, I know. Yep. This is the thing. It's so funny that people, I think this is why I always promote RB Dog Trainer. I'll tell you why. we're making a focus one tomorrow. We're making a focus one tomorrow. This is why I always give, you know, what time is it? It's 9:37 Eastern Standard Time, 6:37 Pacific Standard Time. If you're in London, France, or Germany, or Australia, ask me and I'll let you know what the time is there. Also, I can multiply up to four digits at once. All right? So what I want you to do is...
Four on top and four on the bottom?
Yep. Yep. Should I correct my dog if he keeps looking back at the other dog? You can do a light correction. Yes, you can go to the barbecue, but you cannot bring your dog. If you're not going to my seminar, but you want to go to the barbecue because you're a fan, you can go, but you can't bring your dog. Do I love Russia? Dobro dem. I love Russia. I love Putin.
Do you know he has a sexy calendar?
No, I will not be going back to Rhode Island. But John is an awesome trainer. John is an awesome trainer.
Did you know that, Jeff?
Okay, I'm going to focus on this. No, I didn't know. John's an awesome trainer. Which dog is yours? Which dog is yours that's in board and train? Because I get all the photos and I talk to John a bunch of times a week. How to correct OCD, dog obsessive on light, shadows, laser, is you correct it. Correct it for doing it. Most likely it was used with a laser, someone trained it with a laser pen. What time, he wants to know what time the barbecue is. I think it starts at 6. Oh, Dakota and Buster. Oh, great. Awesome. Yep. Yep. John's there. John and the staff are there. Yep. John and the staff are there. They do a great job. They do a great job. Yep. John does a great job with the dogs. All right. Yeah, I travel the world doing seminars right now. I'll be back in beginning of March, I'll be back. And then I've got a bunch of seminars in Rhode Island that I'm doing, and then I'm also heading out to Australia, right? Next. Oh, so laser pen, do down and do place, and then break the spinning around and break the chasing. How do you build drive? That's a sport dog question. That's a sport dog question. This is what I would do, though. I would do food by only using food to train, meaning the only way the dog eats is through food. Michael Ellis has a really good video on how to build drive in a dog. All sport dog people know how to do that way better than me. Why? Most of my clients, they want their dog to be calmed down. That's why. They want their dog to be calmed down. 2:14 to 2:12. I'll be here. Yeah, you don't need your dogs. It was funny the other day on my birthday. I just turned 50 years old last week, and somebody was like, I got like 700 birthday wishes, which drove me nuts because I had to thank every single person. Personally, I do that. That's just, I wrote thank you to every single person. I didn't just want to do a blanket one. And I did a blanket one as well. But somebody write, I guess I should write something cute, like, you know, have an apps of positivity day or something like that. Like, thank you for the kind gesture. But guess what? I'm not one of those dog freaks. All right. I got like, I don't have a dog on the brain. I got a lot. I'd rather talk about putting fresh water wells in African villages than talking about dogs all the time. I mean, there's a lot of other things I do. Tori, you the same way?
Yeah, I don't.
Yeah, like I'd rather talk.
You know what, Jeff?
What?
You're full of baloney.
I'd rather talk about business than dogs. Hey, nobody asked you, Pipsqueak. Okay. All right. Tried bonking today with my last opposite chasing cat in the house. She was not. Try again. See that? There you go. Bonking victory. Bonking victory. Hail Gary Wilkes. Hail Gary Wilkes. That's great. Look at that. What else? Linda, I'd rather talk business than freaking dogs. You're kidding me. History of toilets.
Might be something we want to talk about in private.
Okay. Let's talk about it right now. Okay, we have to do the rest of the show. What else do we got? Your dog, too loud. Don't let your dog, bonk your dog, remote collar correct your dog. Don't let your dog out the window. Yeah, the towel thing. Yep, the towel thing. Yep.
Tonight, do a screenshot with girl.
Maybe. I'll do a screenshot with girl. I'll do a screenshot with three dogs in it.
You know what I was just thinking? You could pick her up and put her on your lap, and then that reminded me of that, what you did in Fredericksburg.
Who saw the walking tour of, no, I don't do Alpha Roll. Most people that do Alpha Roll are doing it wrong, and they're going to get their face bit off. Alpha Roll is not a correction. It should be done after a correction. I don't do Alpha Rolling at all. Who saw that St. Petersburg, St. Augustine? Who saw the St. Augustine? Wasn't that fun? The walk through St. Augustine? Yeah.
Or the toilet.
No, no, not the, not the, the toilet was fun too. But no, just the, just the walking through all the shops and going in and getting the jerky. Wasn't that fun? The Fredericksburg dog in the store. That was fun.
That was so funny. Girl was like, what the heck?
That was fun. A lot of good stuff are happening on this trip, right? We had a lot of good memories from the first leg of the trip. I know. Yep. We've done about, what have we done? About 10, 11, but we've done about 10,000 miles already. I know, Street Glider. Wasn't that good?
I love that shit.
Yeah, it's true.
I love that shit.
I know. It's true. When they were coming up with Periscope, that's what they envisioned, by the way. That's what they envisioned. They envisioned people all around the world doing like shots into their world and shot and views into their world. So you can log into anybody's Periscope and just see what's going on. All right, what else do we got? Any more questions?
No.
No more questions, guys. It's early. Let's get some questions going. Questions. Have to reveal my pippy before boot camp. Any ideas on rescues? Nope. Nope. Don't know. Don't know. Don't know at all. I don't know. I'm not in that world. I'm not in that world. I wouldn't know what to do. I wouldn't know what to do.
There's a program for called what Dogs on Deployment, I think, where they do a foster program.
There's Dogs on Deployment?
People who foster dogs for people that are going overseas. And
stuff. Yep. Dogs on Deployment. Look that up. I don't know. I'm not in the rescue world. What else? Heart me up. Heart me up. Share this. Kid on the little character in the corner. Do I have a focus video? I'm doing a focus Periscope tomorrow. But yes, I also have a focus video. Have you thought about making a DVD for business? Yes, I have.
You should.
4 years, yeah. You're going to be over there for 4 years, yeah. Aww. So, yeah. Well, thank you for your service. And I don't have anybody. My dog is to control the fetch game and run away with the ball. How to change? Stop playing fetch. Stop playing fetch. Teach the dog to out it. Remote collar, train your dog on proper fetch. So recall the dog out. Recall the dog out. Recall the dog out. Okay? The Indian food guy was hilarious. That was on the first trip. We're going to do a recap after this trip also about people's favorite moments. This is what I love about Periscope is I take you on my travels. We do two, three. I've done seven Periscopes in a day before. Seven. All right. Okay. Seven Periscopes.
And pissed off your family.
All right. Seven of them. Your dog always leans on people or sits on their feet. Seems more lazy than aggressive, but how to stop it? This is how you stop it. Don't let your dog do it. Don't let your dog do it. Why does your dog have that much control? Leash on the dog, put the dog somewhere else. Put the dog somewhere else, right? So have the dog go to place, have the dog go to a down. Keep your dog away that you know, far away from people. Do my dogs alert you if the strangers approach? No, they do not, but girl does go into alert, but she doesn't bark because that would be annoying because there's always people walking by the RV. There's always people walking by the RV. But she definitely goes into alert. So if I'm sitting doing social media and somebody's walking by, she'll go into alert. Desensitizing your dogs to fireworks and thunder, get a CD. Get a CD of all those sound effects. Start it really, really low. Start increasing the sound. Start increasing the sound. All right, increasing the sound. And do food training during all of that. Do food training during all of that.
After a month of nearly perfect behavior, dog starts to test and snaps when corrected.
Yep, that sounds about right. That sounds about right. Your dog's just literally testing you. So guess what you do? Nope. Nope. Not me. I got your game. I got your number, buddy. Okay? I got your number. It's called the honeymoon period. It's over. The dog was manipulating you. So you might have gotten a little bit loosey-goosey on some of your rules. Tighten up and correct. Tighten up and correct. All right? Tighten up and correct.
What height fence would I get for a lab?
6-foot fence should do it. Lab shouldn't try to jump the fence. All right? So.
My shepherd is still struggling with high anxiety. I swear this boy is
too scared to sleep. So nitwit. If you've tried my separation anxiety protocol, if you're using a lot of my advice, that's a Periscope, that's a Skype visit so you can get more focused training. Yeah, YouTube's got great sounds. Yep, just download, you can make your own YouTube soundtrack of sounds. everything. Who's the serious gal behind me? What's your name?
Victoria.
Victoria?
Today.
We did a Skype already. Did we finish a Skype or do you still have another 30 minutes left? Because a lot of people only do 30-minute Skypes. Then you should, if we've already done a Skype and you're one of my clients, there's some major stuff going on. If you're doing everything I suggested, everything I suggested. If we've only done half a Skype, Nitwit, if we've only done half a Skype, you've got more time. Or I'll be more than happy to give you a 10-minute session at no cost. Something's going on. It's like 45 minutes. So you got 15 minutes left. Schedule it with my office. Call my office. You're going to get a minimum of 15 minutes and we're going to recheck. You were supposed to do that anyway with me, probably. I tell everybody that Skypes with me, remember, if you Skype with me and then you also want to ask on Periscope, I don't sometimes put two and two together. In other words, like Periscope is not official. Periscope is not official. Jeff, I trained one of my dogs place and now he won't get up. Do me a favor. The super glue, it's supposed to be used for modeled airplanes, not dogs. Yes, correct your dog when it's whining. Yes, correct your dog when it's whining. Absolutely. You can correct a fearful, anxious dog. You can correct a fearful, anxious dog. It will not make them worse. They're already worse. Yes. Put the leash on the dog, make him move. Mm-hmm. Very good. Yes.
If you start using an e-collar, are you going to have to use it forever?
If you start using an e-collar, you're going to have to use it forever. All my dogs are naked, so my dogs have no collars. Do you always have to be training? Yes, you do. But an e-collar is not a failure in training. An e-collar is a life saver. So I've got health insurance. I've got car insurance. I've got homeowner's insurance. I wear my seatbelt. I have a will, right? It is a what if. It's a what if collar. A what if collar. My dog struggles with the release command. He waits for a leash tug always. Am I doing it wrong? I would switch to remote collar. Your dog doesn't understand what break means. So break or free, what are you using? Which word are you using? And your dog probably doesn't understand what the word means. So your dog whines all the time and gets corrections so much that he gets, so something's going on. So stop giving the corrections and there's something else going on with your dog. So you say, okay. Yeah, don't say okay. Say break. Break is more break. Break. Because you use okay in your normal language all the time. So. Girl had a, I trained her 3 months on a remote collar. And she hasn't had a collar for over, she's about 4 years old, probably for 3 years. She hasn't had a collar on.
Good night, Jean.
But I'm a dog trainer. And I also hit the jackpot with girl. And girl goes everywhere with me. Like I've put 40,000 miles on this RV. She's ridden all 40,000 miles. So she's always with me. So girl is just always with me doing stuff. So a lot of that's just by default, meaning I can grunt and she'll like turn around and come to me. I can just like make a noise. So it's a little bit different. So I hit the jackpot with girl. Who named her? I did. Who do you think named her? Come on. Who's the creative guy in this family? Me.
Hey, I named the new dog.
You did. You named our new dog, Kira. I know. You know that dog that was shot in Canton, Ohio? The police dog, the police canine that was shot? He's actually the guy that trained that dog is training one of my dogs right now. And they're it's terrible. It's terrible. Yep. Jethro. Yep. Jethro and Ryan. Yeah, it's terrible. Oh, Norfolk one was, yeah. I'm picking up Kira as a female, and I'm picking Kira up in March. The trainer's name is Eric, and the owner of the dog that got shot is Ryan, and the dog's name is Jethro. Jethro died. Yeah, it's terrible. The great dog, awesome dog, and the dog that trained that dog is actually the one that's training
the man.
Kira. Yep, the guy. the trainer for the Canton Canine Division. Yep.
I got some questions.
They're all torn up. Yep. Go ahead.
Dog is super excited when other dogs are around and barks. How can I tell if he is aggressive?
The only way to tell if your dog is aggressive, and I don't recommend people doing this by themselves, is you would have to have your dog off leash around other dogs, around stable dogs. And if the dog attacks them, that's aggression. If it's off leash. So we'd muzzle up your dog and we'd see. So that's how we do it. That's how we do it. Why do I have someone else training my dog? Because I don't know how to do BOM or tracking or protection work. That's why. So I imported her from Holland and she's going to be a very specialized dog. She's going to be a very specialized working dog. I don't know how to do any of that training. There's an open memorial service. Yeah, I got the press release on that. Yeah. Ciangelo, yeah. Are you in Canton? Are you in Ohio? Do you know them? Are you part of the K-9 team or the police department? Yeah, you are? Yeah, man, my heart's out. My heart's out. Yeah, it sucks. It really sucks. When any dog dies, it sucks. But when a working dog dies, not to put more value on their life, but they've got, you know, yeah. What would her job be? I'm going to be doing bomb detection for private industry. And then for fun, I'll probably do bite work, and I might get her involved with tracking. She can track down, you know, dogs. So, yeah, teaching your dog how to go boar hunting, that'll be fun. Yep, you absolutely can have a calm house dog and a gun dog as well. Absolutely. Girl is a high drive dog. So where is she? Girl here? So girl is a high drive dog, you know, So most people have only seen her like in drive, but she's not. Hold on. Come here, girl, please. Nine. Good. Yeah. A gun dog, just like a hunting dog, or a hunting trial dog, gun dog. You go out and you shoot and then they swim out and they get the birds. I think that's what that person meant by gun dog. Yeah.
Blind Pomeranian is going deaf and getting aggressive.
Yeah.
The vet has prescribed Prozac.
That won't help. That won't help at all. So what happens when you've got a blind and deaf dog, your dog needs you to advocate for it. Keep that dog on a leash, and I would use a lot of sense. So use sense, meaning use where its kennel is, you have a scent. Where the indoor, where the back door is, have a scent. So if you want your dog to go, if it's in the backyard, if it's off leash in the backyard because you have a fenced in area and it wants to come in, you take a scent, some essential oil, you put it on the outside of the door so the dog can smell it. On the inside of the door, what you can do is you can have a tiny fan blowing. So the dog knows where the fan blows. That's where the door is to go outside. So you've got a doggy door. But what's happening is your dog can't hear or see, so it's being startled. That's what's happening, is your dog is being startled. So what you're gonna have to do is advocate for your dog. The cool thing is your dog can smell, most likely its sense of smell has been heightened because it's more aware of it because the other senses have been blocked out. So what's happening is, say if a strange dog runs up to it, that's probably why it would be aggressive. If it's dogs that it's living with, that's a whole different issue, and you're gonna have to advocate for that dog by always making sure everything in that house slows down. Everything in that house slows down, right? But Prozac, if anything, I would not do Prozac. If anything, I would think that would be even more confusing. It's new dogs, yeah. So I would absolutely keep new dogs away from your dog right now. Yep, absolutely. Question about a neighbor's dog. Anytime he sees another dog on his walk, he lays down. Why? Probably wants to play. That's sort of like pre-play, you know, pre-play.
Dog ate the wall through its kennel overnight. How can I make her understand that it is not acceptable?
Wow, nitwit. Let's talk about all this stuff on our Skype. That's intense. Did you have that? How could that do it in the kennel? Hey, Russia, don't put them in the kennel. Like, what is it? Plastic? Is it a very kennel? It ate through. That's a problem. That's a different dog. Yes to the kennel. A metal kennel? Oh, I would correct that as soon as I would correct the dog for that. So you gotta put a camera on it. So what you gotta do is you put a camera on it, and then you've got to make sure you correct it. But also make sure you got, you know, make sure you're exercising that dog enough. Oh, hey, how you doing, Australia? I'll be over there soon. Yeah, we'll talk about all these dogs on our Skype visit. How's that?
Listen, we have 2 minutes and we have a handful.
Okay, go ahead. We have 2 minutes left.
My dog is fully potty trained, but it goes pee and poo in the house sometimes. How do I correct that?
All right, so it's not fully potty trained. So what I want you to do is where are your eyes on that dog, and why does it have free roaming? So what I would do is I would, first of all, have it medically checked out. What I'll also do is I would also start keeping that dog, crate it at night, crate it when you're not home, no free roaming, put it on a routine, make sure you're feeding in its food and water are on a routine, make sure it's not overeating as well. Also, log the time when it's doing it and try to figure out why. Why is it doing it? There has to be a reason why. And is it when you're not around, you can't leave your dog out of your sight right now. You can't. It sucks. I'd rather have an aggressive dog than a dog that shits and pisses in the house. Your Corso has been trained with treats. That's fine as well, but is inconsistent, ready for a new concept. New concept. Well, training is training. So to me, what I would do is we remote collar train all our dogs. So it's just another form of communication with your dog. So it's a little bit stronger because you can be a little bit more consistent with it. And you can also whisper or shout to your dog up to a mile away. So I would switch over to, you know, if your dog knows something but it's not being consistent with it, that means there has to be a level of correction at some point for non-compliance. But different tools can both motivate as well as correct. So, all right. No free roaming is you can't just walk around the house without supervision. Like Angelo. We don't allow free roaming with Angelo. Angelo's our 3-year-old. He gets no free roaming. We have to know where he is or what room he's in. So he sort of gets free roaming because if he's in a room. When a dog doesn't want to work, do you withhold? Well, we never withhold food. What we do is we use, if you're doing a food training protocol and the dog doesn't take the food because they're not getting the command, then yeah, they're done. They're done. They're done. They're done. And then you put them up and you take them back out. Take them back out in the afternoon. Do it some more. Yep. That's if you're doing a food training protocol. Or you can just put a leash on the dog and a training collar on the dog. And you have to use some motivation. So you can use an aversive. You can use pressure. You can use food. You can use, you know, so. But if the dog doesn't want to take the food, you know, then it's not going to do it. Girl's got to go outside. That's why she's doing this nonsense. Shoot.
Well, yep. We should really hurry.
One more question.
If dog has been trained with without an e-collar, sit, place, down, etc., but has other issues, should we retrain with the e-collar?
Yeah, I mean, you should use a remote collar, but you don't have to retrain. Just it'll be easy. Your dog will understand the technology. See, once you understand the concept of a remote collar, you can do anything with one. So your dog will get it. Your dog will be fine. So yes, to answer your question, but training sit down in place, all you'll be doing is layering, all right? You know, all you'll be doing is layering, you know? I've got videos on a remote collar. Also my colleague, Sean O'Shea, thegooddog.net, thegooddog.net, just put out a CD, I'm sorry, DVD. Just put out a DVD on remote collar training, all right? So what you can do is, you can go to his DVD. Yeah, people around the world train their dogs with remote collars by watching my free videos. You don't have to have a trainer. You don't have to have a trainer. 13-week-old boxer pup tips for starting crate training. 13-week-old dog should already be on its way to crate training. So what I would do is this is no free roaming, lots of structure. You go out to the bathroom, you put it on a leash, you go out the same door every time, make the dog wait at the threshold, take it out to the same potty spot, tell it to go to the bathroom, come back in, kennel it back up, and then, if you're going to work the dog, have the dog come back out. No free roaming with your 13-week-old dog. Lots of structure. You should be working on all your obedience command. Do a food training protocol right now. You can start layering the remote collar over it in about a week or so. All right? All right. The show is officially over. Ah, let's get a selfie with girl. Hold on. Nine. So everybody take a picture of this dog right here. And you're going to take a screenshot. Does everyone know how to do a screenshot? Do a screenshot. And then you're going to tweet it to me. So you do a screenshot, and then you go to your Twitter account, and you do at solid, right, do a message, and you do at solid canine, I'm sorry, at solid canine training, and attach this photo, and put I love girl, and I'll send you a video. So screenshot, tweet it with I love girl. Screenshot, tweet it with I love girl. Nobody's doing a screenshot. And then you can also do a screenshot of these two little characters. And a screenshot too. No, we don't. These chihuahuas are not trained. They're not trained. They walk on a leash. They go to place. They kennel up. Bad connection. Could be the Periscope gods. So screenshot there. Screenshot girl. But can chihuahuas be remote collar trained? Yes, they can. Absolutely. And screenshot here. Yep, one of the dogs did. There was that huge, what was that dog? Was it a Mastiff? Not a Mastiff. I forgot that what kind of dog. Yeah, it was a huge 200-pound dog.
I think it was a Mastiff.
Mastiff, yeah. All right. And this is the kids, which you don't want you screenshotting. Thank you very much. Angela, are you up? You sleeping? Angela, are you up? Hey, buddy. He's tired. Move away from those wires, okay? Girls, hook him up. Put him back. Put him in his corner. He's tired. Do you use prongs on the little guys? Yeah, we do. We have. We've used tiny little prong collars on them, but they just get little leashes. They just get little leashes. That's all they need, little leashes. And Linda will be doing a Periscope tonight. Linda's going to be doing a Periscope tonight. And don't forget, I'm also going to be interviewing this lady right here about T3. We're redoing our T3 one because we had technical difficulties last night. So we're redoing our T3 one. All right. So Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. We're going to take a quick 10-minute, 15-minute break. I'm going to move inside Tori's house, and then we're going to do another Periscope. Madly in love with you. Take care, everybody. I feel honored and blessed that I can teach. And if it wasn't for people out there, I wouldn't have any students. But I also love to learn every day as well. Thank you. So watch. So, oops, hold on. Let me just turn off this.
So I think those Periscope.